Good morning, friends. Yesterday, or in the last lecture, we can say that we have discussed about the romantic age, as in our paper CC6, the age which is being talked about is romantic age. So first let us discuss what the romantic age is. In the previous lectures we have studied that romantic age is an artistry, literary, musical and intellectual movement that started in Europe at the end of 18th century, and its pioneer was considered as William Wordsworth, preface to lyrical ballads. But it was the reaction of the two great revolutions which was started, that one is the French Revolution and the other one is Industrial Revolution. French Revolution, as the name suggests, that it was started in France, and in this revolution the people saw that there was a social imbalance in the society, and due to that this revolution came into existence. While in the Industrial Revolution, we can say that industries were flourishing at that time, and the side effects caused this revolution, Industrial Revolution. Okay, so these two revolutions were considered as the basis, so that the reaction of this revolution is now said to be the romantic age. It has a significant and complex effect on politics, with romantic thinkers influencing liberalism, radicalism, conservatism and nationalism. Okay, not only in literature but many other fields this romantic age could be seen. It is seen in the music, it is seen in the social science, natural science, paintings, then many other things. Okay, then we came to the etymology, that is the meaning of the word roman. It started the word roman in various European languages has a complicated history, but in general sense it is said to be the work of popular narrative fiction. Then comes the period. The period was between that is the end of the 18th century. Okay, then its features. The features we have seen that the first feature was imagination, that the imagination is must for a romantic poet. If there is no imagination, there could be no natural effect will be seen in any of the poetries, and so imagination is must. Then the second one was emotional. The poet should have emotions, so that the poetries get the emotion transferred to the readers through the poets. Okay, then the third one was the overcrowdedness and the polluted environment. Okay, due to that, the third feature was that back to nature. Means what? Nature had all the goodness in it, and the city life was being crowded, and it was seen that there was no emotion left. Okay, except the exploitations done to the women and children, no other things were seen, and so the romantic poets felt that back to nature is only the reason, or only the way the people can get freedom from their thoughts and imagination. And the fourth one was the role of nature. Okay, the nature, the view of nature, the role of nature was must for any romantic poet. Okay, as per the example we have seen, that P.B. Shelley's line, "If winter comes, can spring be far behind?" means what? Here the in the background area we can see that the poet P.B. Shelley has discussed about the seasons winter and spring. Okay, but later on we can see that winter is symbolized as death, while the spring is symbolized as the rebirth of nature. So the truth or divinity of the nature is seen in this type of romantic poetries. Then we have seen the different types of poetries. First one is pastoral poetry, which means the depiction of the pleasure in rural life. Then comes the nature poetry, means what? The reflection of nature in the primitive men. Then oceanic poetry means melancholy and suffering produced by war on contrast love. Okay, and the wild and gloomy nature is being portrayed in oceanic poetry. And the last one was graveyard poetry, which depicts the graveyards, death, immorality, life and death, etc., etc., etc. Then we have seen the Gothic novels. Gothic novels are the one which has the impulse of for freedom and escape from the ugly world, and lastly by the fear of trump of evil over good. Okay, in the last, in the end of the novel, Gothic novels, we can see that always the good or the positive side wins over the negative side. The first one to write Gothic novel was Horace Walpole. His novel name was The Castle of Otranto. Okay, now comes the Romantic Age authors, the well-known authors of Romantic Age. First, the period which extends from 1798 to 1837 is known as the Romantic Age. The term Romantic was used in England for the first time in 16th century to indicate the unreal and fanciful elements. During 18th century, it was used with negative connotation to indicate something in contrast with reason but linked with emotion. The Romantic Age was said to be started in England in 16th century, around 16th century, which indicates the unreal elements which were dwelling at that time. The first among these romantic poets is our well-known poet William Wordsworth. Okay, we will take a short biography of every well-known poet so that we can have a brief idea of the poets which were there in the Romantic Age. The William Wordsworth was born in English Lake District in 1770 and he was educated in Cambridge. In 1790, he went on walking tour of France and the Alps, where he had been influenced by the ideas of French Revolution. So he was born in English Lake District and educated in Cambridge. This is the biography, so I'm just reading it. Okay. In 1790, he went on a walking tour of France and Alps, where he had an influence by the ideas of French Revolution. Once upon a time, he went to France and there he saw the French Revolution. The development of the revolution and the war between France and England brought him to the edge of nervous breakdown. Nervous breakdown means eat parina tutina bhangigyo, seeing all these situations. In 1795, he went to live with his sister, his most faithful friend. So in 1795, he went back to the England and lived with his sister, whom he considered as one of the faithful friend of him. Then he moved to Somerset to be near to Samuel Taylor Coleridge, his very close friend, S.T. Coleridge. He moved to Somerset to live with him. The development of their friendship brought them to write a collection of poems called Lyrical Ballads, published in 1798. This is the said to be the first romantic work or combined work of William Wordsworth and S.T. Coleridge, anonymously, and in 1800, containing Wordsworth preface, The Manifesto of English Romanticism. In 1799, he went to live in the Lake District and he got married. Okay. So again he went back to Lake District in 1799, okay, and he got married. And in 1800 he wrote the preface to the Lyrical Ballads, which is said to be the manifesto or the pillar of we can say the milestone where the building is built. That is, the Romantic Age was built. That is Lyrical preface to Lyrical Ballads. In 1805 he had finished the prelude, a long autobiographical poem, in 14 books. His reputation grew in 1843. He was made poet laureate. He died in 1850. Okay, so he completed his world famous book, that is the prelude, which is considered as his autobiographical poem, that is divided into 14 books. Okay, in 1805 he had finished it, and in 1843 he was made poet laureate. It is one of the greatest achievement for the poets, to get the poet laureate, and he was made so in 1843. He died in 1850, within 7 years of getting the well-known poet laureate. He died in 1850. The main topic of Wordsworth's poetry are everyday situation and common people. Wordsworth think that the neoclassical poets, okay, or any literary person, they all mention the countryside area, okay, and not the current situation which is going on and all that. So he was totally opposing it, and so he discussed in his poetry everyday situation and common people. Okay, suppose if we if a child cries for the food, okay, it is a natural thing, okay, it is an everyday situation. So he takes that topic and writes a poetry. Okay, his world famous Daffodils poem. Okay, it is said that once he was traveling in a train, and at a glance he saw this flower daffodil, and at a moment only he thought to write about it. Now we can see that this is a everyday situation, that we travel and see many things around us. Okay, but he used to write such things only, which is considered as everyday situation, and it is for common people. He uses simple language. Okay, he now these are the characteristics of his poem, or we can say the characteristics of a romantic age. Okay, a romantic age poetry. He used the simple language, so that now see. It is very obvious that if the poem is about common people, and if the characters are the common people in any of the literature, then it is very obvious that the language used in it will be common language or simple language only. If the poem or any literature is about king or prince or anything, then the language would not be the simple language. The tragedies of Shakespeare. In that we can see that the language is very tough. It is the Middle English, so that type of English is very difficult to understand for any common people. Even we can't recognize what the meaning is at a first glance. So here Wordsworth say that he used a simple language so that the common people can understand his poetry very well. The most important theme of his poetry is nature. Okay, the portrayal of nature is the basic element of his poetry. He thought the man and nature are inseparable. Okay, he shared Rousseau's faith in the goodness of nature, and he believed in deep link between man and nature. Okay, he thought the man and nature are inseparable. Natural comforts man in sorrow and help him to love. So he had a pantheistic view. According to him, it is said that man and nature are close to each other. Okay, so they can't be separated. Okay, and the feeling of love, compassion, everything comes from the nature only. Okay, so it is said that the nature is the one who gives a person's emotions such as love, sorrow, etc. Wordsworth believed that memory was very important because it allows the poet to give poetry its life and power. The importance of memory influences poetry because it takes origin from emotion recollected in tranquility. The poet is a teacher who shows men how to understand their feelings and improve their moral being. According to Wordsworth, memory is must for writing any poetry, because through memory only emotions are being collected by the poet, and the poet through that emotion writes the poetry. Okay, so this is Wordsworth. Now we can see that Wordsworth deals only with the nature and its goodness. Okay, now there are various poets in Romantic age who describes about nature, but there are poets who discuss good about the nature. Well, some of the poets, like the next one we are doing, that is Coleridge, they think that the evil side of the nature is being portrayed in their poetry. Okay, now let us discuss about Samuel Taylor Coleridge. He was the friend, or very good friend, of Wordsworth. Samuel Taylor Coleridge was born in Devonshire in 1772. He was sent first to the Christ Hospital School and then to Cambridge, where he never graduated. Okay, this is the biography of Samuel Taylor Coleridge, or in short we can say ST Coleridge. He was influenced by French revolutionary ideals, but after the disillusionment, and he and the poet Southey planned to establish a utopian community in Pennsylvania under the name of Pentisocracy, but the project came to nothing. Okay, he was also influenced by French Revolution, just as William Wordsworth, but after the disillusionment, he thought to establish a community with the well-known poet Southey, but the project was not successful due to many reasons. In 1797, he met William Wordsworth and he settled in Somerset with William Wordsworth. Earlier, we have seen that William Wordsworth also settled in Somerset. Okay, so along with him, in 1797, he also settled with him. In this year, he wrote The Rime of Ancient Mariner, the first poem of lyrical ballads, Christabel, that was unfinished, and Kubla Khan, that was also unfinished. He wrote many great poems. Okay, among them, these three are the world famous. The first is The Rime of Ancient Mariner, then Christabel and Kubla Khan. In that, The Rime of Ancient Mariner is said to be the first poem of lyrical ballads, the combined work of William Wordsworth and Samuel Taylor Coleridge, while the other two, that is Christabel and Kubla Khan, that two are unfinished work. In 1799, he moved to the Lake District, and then he spent a period of solitude in Malta. In 1817, he settled in London, where he produced Biographia Literaria. He died in 1834. He gave his very well-known critical theory, Biographia Literaria, in London, when he was settled in 1817, okay, and he died in 1834. Imagination for Coleridge is very important, and he divided it into two kinds. Okay, here in Biographia Literaria, the critical work or critical theory given by him, he discussed imagination, and he divided into two parts. Okay, here we will keep up to this, okay, and we will continue it in the next lecture. Hope you are understanding what I am telling, and please go through whatever we have studied till now, okay, and thank you for your cooperation, and don't forget to comment your name and roll number in the comment section, and yes, see you in the next lecture. Thank you.